Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa usalli wa usallimu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabiyyina wa habibina wa qurrati a'yunina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi afdalu salati wa atamu taslim, amma ba'd. All praise and thanks be to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah ta'ala, for tonight's heart softener, we will be touching on a missing element from today's society. And that missing element is haya, which is modesty, purity, and being shy. All of these meanings are incorporated within the word haya. Haya, as the Arabs say, al-haya'u mushtaqum min al-haya'ah. Al-haya'u mushtaqum min al-haya'ah. That the word haya is derived, the Arabic word haya is derived from another Arabic word. Both of the words are derived from the same root. Haya is derived from al-haya, which means modesty is derived from the word al-haya, which means life. Allahu Akbar. Al-haya is derived from the word al-haya, which is life. So scholars say that if an individual's heart is alive, if it is soft, supple, and absorbing that which is good, then the element of haya, the element of modesty, will be complete in that individual's heart. But on the other hand, if that individual's heart is riddled with diseases, then the levels of modesty begin to deplete and begin to decrease. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And worse situation is if that individual's heart is dead, Allahu Akbar. If that individual's heart is dead, if it is dark and become hard, then haya is also dead, modesty is also dead. So this is how closely connected, haya is to an individual's heart. This is how closely connected modesty is to an individual's heart. Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma is reported to have said that iman and haya go hand in hand. Iman and haya are connected together very closely in an individual's heart. For if iman, he says that if one of the two were to leave, the other will follow in suit. Say for example, if iman were to leave the heart of an individual, then haya also would leave the heart of that individual. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. And if haya leaves the heart of an individual, if modesty leaves the heart of an individual, iman also will gradually leave the heart of that particular individual. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. So haya is divided into two categories. Modesty is divided into two categories. One is that we have a good type of haya, a good type of a modesty, and then we have a bad type of a modesty too. A good type of a modesty and a bad type of a modesty. The good type of modesty divides itself once again into two. Number one, al-haya'ul fitri, al-haya'ul jibilli. Al-haya'ul fitri is that naturally ingrained modesty in your heart. All of us, in our natural disposition, in our fitrah, Allah the Almighty has ingrained a natural sense of haya, a natural sense of modesty. Say for example, none of us would walk on the streets completely naked. Why? Because we have that natural sense of haya within us. None of us would resort to committing sexual acts with our wives in public because we have that natural sense of haya. But sadly today when you look around, even that natural sense of haya has been plucked away from some individuals. May Allah the Almighty save us all. We have places where people gather together completely nude and they do all kinds of wild acts because Allah the Almighty has plucked away that sense of natural haya from them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. The second type of haya, from the good type of haya, is الحياء الإيماني. الله أكبر. And that haya is a type of haya which needs to be earned. It is a modesty which needs to be earned. The more you develop your iman, the more the levels of your iman grow, that haya also grows. And that haya is an encouraged type of a haya. That haya, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is the haya, is the modesty that will keep you away from sins. It is the modesty that will make you feel ashamed to commit a sin. It will make you feel ashamed to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to transgress the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would feel ashamed to use the faculties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with to commit a sin, to transgress the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You would feel ashamed to use the eyes that Allah the Almighty has given you to look at things that are haram. The mouth that Allah has given you to utter, to articulate things that are haram. The ears that Allah has given you to hear things that are haram. The nose that Allah has given you to perhaps smell those things that are haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. The perfume or the fragrance of a non-mahram woman is haram. So even any faculty of ours should not be used to transgress the limits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we develop that haya al-imani, we will stay away from all those things that will anger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salman the Persian radiyallahu anhu, he states that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if Allah the Almighty decrees doom upon an individual, Allah the Almighty plucks away haya from that individual. Allah plucks away modesty from that individual, resulting in that individual becoming rebellious and defiant to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah the Almighty save us all. Moving on to the bad type of haya, we'll swiftly cover that. That haya is not encouraged, it is blameworthy, and it is not something that we need to adopt. The bad type of haya is that haya where a person feels ashamed to uphold the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He feels ashamed to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is a bad type of haya, that is a bad type of modesty which is not encouraged at all. He feels ashamed to adhere to the teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teachings of Islam because he's ashamed to adopt the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He suffers complexes to look like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he's ashamed to adopt the lifestyle of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that is the bad type of haya which we should stay away completely from. My beloved Shaykh Imam Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he states that if an individual commits something in secret, if an individual commits something, a sin in secret, that he is ashamed to commit in the public, that means he does not have haya, and also he does not have any self-respect at all for himself. Allahu Akbar. Because he's ashamed to do it in public, but he doesn't mind doing it in the privacy of his home or of his room. He doesn't mind doing it in secret. He is forgetting that Allah the Almighty, who gave over 1 billion human beings the sight to see, that Allah is not blind to our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of what we do. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, and the hadith is in Bukhari, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاسْنَعْ مَا شِئْتْ. If you don't have haya, if you don't feel ashamed, if you don't feel modest, then do whatever you will. Do whatever you want. You can be whatever you want, even walk on the streets naked. If you don't have haya, do whatever you want. Because scholars explain, as haya leaves you, iman also will gradually leave you. Let me share with you all the beautiful story of Imam Abdullah ibn Maslama al-Qanabi, rahimahullah. One day, there was a young street urchin who was known as Abdullah. He was a street urchin who used to run around causing all kinds of mischief and doing what not. One day he was seated outside his house and he was having a dagger in his hand and he was planning to do some mischief. At that time he sees a group of people approaching him. There was a person riding a donkey or a horse and he had students around him, gathering around him. So the minute that convoy or that gathering passed him, This young boy, Abdullah, asks the students, who is this person on the horse or on the donkey? What is the big deal about him? Why are you following him? Then the students said that this is Imam Shu'bah ibn al-Hajjaj. He was a great Imam of Hadith and we are his students. Oh, so he is a great Imam of Hadith? Then let me go up to him and ask him to relate a Hadith to me so that I can relate from him. Oh, Shu'bah, relate a Hadith unto me. Now Imam Shu'bah said, this is not the way a student of knowledge seeks knowledge. Why don't you come to our circles and then seek knowledge from me? And you have to develop your character and your behavior if you want to become a student of knowledge. To which he said, no, I'm not going to leave you. I will cause a big ruckus here if you don't narrate a hadith to me. And he starts pointing the dagger at the Imam. Allahu Akbar. The Imam then says, he uses the opportunity to teach this individual something. He narrates this very hadith that I narrated to you all now. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. He narrated the hadith with its full chain. And he said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ is reported to have said, إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. If you don't have modesty, if you don't have haya, do whatever you want. The minute the Imam uttered those words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this street urchin, his name was Abdullah, it struck a chord in his heart, and it was as if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam materialized in front of him, and it was as if Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, may my mother, my father, and myself be sacrificed for him and be ransomed for him. It was as if he had come in front of him and was advising him. He immediately turned back home. And that was the pivotal moment that he changed his life completely. He turned and changed his life completely and turned over a new leaf and started his journey on seeking knowledge. Allahu Akbar. He travels all the way to Imam Malik, rahimahullah. And he becomes one of the most famous students of Imam Malik, rahimahullah. And after a long period of seeking knowledge, he comes back to where he was, his hometown, because he wanted to become a student of Imam Shu'bah, the very Imam that he had pointed the dagger at. But by the time he comes back, Imam Shu'bah, rahimahullah, had passed away. And this young boy, Abdullah, later on becomes the great Imam, Al-Imam Abdullah ibn Maslama Al-Qa'nabi. He was a student of Imam Malik, rahimahullah, a great muhaddith, Allahu Akbar. And the only hadith, that he narrates from Imam Shu'bah is that hadith that he heard after pointing the dagger at him. إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. If you do not have haya, do whatever you will. Because if you do not have haya, gradually iman is going to leave you. That's what scholars say in terms of the explanation of the hadith. So may Allah the Almighty fill all our hearts with beautiful haya, so that we completely stay away from all those things that displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, abiding the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us work on this element, this missing element of haya, and let us adopt it, let us bring it into our lives. Let us become modest, let us become ashamed, let us become shy in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just as how once a student of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah stands up and reads a poem in front of Imam Ahmad. إِذَا مَا قَالَ لِي رَبِّي أَمَسْتَحْيَيْتَ تَعْصِينِي تُخْفِي الذَّنْبَ عَنْ خَلْقِي وَبِالْعِصْيَانِ تَأْتِينِي. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah was astounded. He said, can you please repeat that piece of poetry? The words are translated as, إِذَا مَا قَالَ لِي رَبِّي أَمَسْتَحْيَيْتَ تَعْصِينِي. What will I do when my Lord says to me, were you not ashamed when you were disobeying me? You hid your faults from the creation, but with all of these faults you come in front of me. What will I say to my Lord on that day? Allahu Akbar. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahullah, he keeps hearing this piece of poetry and he started weeping so much to the extent that he had to get up and leave the gathering. And his students go on to say that he entered his house and they could still hear him weeping. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all of our sins. And may He fill our hearts with haya, so that we stay away completely from those things that displease our beloved Maker. And may He forgive our sins. May He accept our good deeds. And may He the Almighty unite all of us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He has united us here tonight with our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu عليه وسلم. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خير. سبحان الله وبحمده سبحانك الله وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك صلى الله على النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.